tasavitulvarenyam bhargo devasya dhimahi dhiyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhogavasvaha tasavitulvarenyam bhargo devasya dhimahi dhiyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasvaha tasavitulvarenyam bhargo devasya dhimahi dhiyo yo na prachodayat. Om shanti shanti shanti.
Om beautiful God, hallelujah. Om beautiful God, hallelujah. Om beautiful God, hallelujah. Om Sri Satya Sai, hallelujah. Sri Satya Sai, hallelujah. Sri Satya Sai, hallelujah. Sai Keshava, hallelujah. Sai Keshava, hallelujah. Sai Keshava, hallelujah. Allah, Allah, hallelujah. Allah, Allah, hallelujah. Allah, Allah, hallelujah. Jehovah, hallelujah. Jehovah, hallelujah. Heavenly Father, hallelujah. Heavenly Father, hallelujah. Heavenly Father, hallelujah. Divine Mother, hallelujah. Divine Mother, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Holy Spirit,
hallelujah. Holy Spirit, hallelujah. Holy Spirit, hallelujah. Hare Rama, hallelujah. Hare Rama, hallelujah. Hare Krishna, hallelujah. Hare Krishna, hallelujah. Hare Krishna, hallelujah. Sweet Lord Buddha, hallelujah. Sweet Lord Buddha, hallelujah. Sweet Lord Buddha, hallelujah. Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Lord Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Baba. Hallelujah, Satya Sai Baba. Hallelujah, Satya Sai Baba.
Divasambodha Concern for the body is the way to realize self-realization. Of what use is human birth if you do not manifest? Of what use is human birth if you do not manifest? Sayonara.
In the Service to the mankind, service to God, and also he also say that we are spark of the divine, so we have the same kind of divinity within us, so we are partly majority, actually we have to transform ourselves to divinity, and unfortunately we have man is a between the social animal and the God, so transformation is an issue. And once you fully transform yourself, and whatever he mentioned, all the problems are solved. But we are not here to solve everybody's problems. Swami said, you change yourself and you change the world. So look within yourself and try to convert yourself to proper Sai devotee essence. And you can see from here all these messages, all human values, these are the basis of that. So in other words, it's every religion tells the same thing. Jesus sacrificed his life for the upliftment of the human being. I think Swami accepted, and Swami accept all the religions. You can see from the other side, you can all the religions. So basically, it's a message of today's last night where we went to the carol and look at the five church, how the people united and holding it, candle night carol, and they are looking for the people, I mean they are remembering the people who lost their lives during this earthquake. When we came in, around 7 o'clock, checked in one of the hotels. Suddenly after 50, I was even googling something. Suddenly the whole building was shaking.
Yes, so
I said, what's going on here? You know, the whole world is shaking here. So I think the whole world could be, maybe Swami shaking us to become ourselves, transform ourselves into another thing. And also after coming here, I got a message from my colleague in Sydney. And he said, the divine message. So I think probably I brought the message, so I got to read it. So that actually is basically, it's a very good message. Swami is around the Christmas in 70s, he mentioned that. So let me read that one so that it is a clear message to everybody, but how much we are going to adapt from there is left to us. If you adapt the complete message, then you don't have to come to Sai Centre. In other words, you are completely transformed yourself. But we are, because people say that you can born in church and don't die in the church. In other words, don't practice, never perfection. So that's the message. So let's read this one to give that. Jesus sacrificed his life and poured out his blood to instill love and compassion in the heart of man, so that you are happy when others are happy and sad when others are sad. Let me call upon you today to give up in honor of this holy occasion two evils from your mind, self-praise and talking scandal. Give them up. Instead, adopt one habit, the habit of loving service to the distressed. If you spend all our time and energy in worldly comfort and sensual delight, you are disgracing this human existence. Do not spend your life in just enjoying food. Eat as much as is necessary for living. Maintain your body as temple where God resides. Keep it clean, fresh and fragrant by developing compassion and love. Let holy thoughts, words and deeds emerge from you. Do not demean it, using it for low, trivial and unholy tasks. Wherever you are, make this resolution today. So in other words, Swami, this, he said in 1970s, in the Christmas day, one of those 70s. So this message is good for 70s, it go to 80s, 90s, 2000, maybe even 3000. He was, how many times telling you the same thing. So in other words, one of the ways of spiritual life is to reinforce, read in spiritual literature, and read it over again, because it's not that one comes and goes here. Because all five senses, what you get, it's not what you eat, what you are, people say. Eat means not only through your mouth, also you absorb all the five senses. So don't see evil, don't see, you know, you don't hear evil, and don't, don't speak evil. All these three monkeys, you know that. So that is a message, I think Swami is telling us over and over again. And we can't add anything more than that. So wherever I go, I find the Sai devotees are much dedicated. I always say whenever in Japan, whenever to Brazil, Mexico, I always admire these people who are Sai devotees. If you go to Argentina or Brazil, they are Catholics. The converted Christians are better Christians than new Christians. Like they are. Swami's word is, for them, it is actually the God word. And unfortunately, we Indians, we take whatever we, part of that, whatever necessary, other one we discard. For them, I can still remember Hira's wife I was interviewing in Japan. She said, 1960, Swami said, don't eat dead animals. That's the word she used. Because Japanese is very difficult to take, you know, from 60s onward, no more meat. So went to Sai Centre, they're having vegetarian all the time. And even 1.5 kilometers away, you can smell the beef food in Sai Centre, Tokyo. I was surprised, you know, the way the fragrance, you know. He said, wherever the spiritual Baba said, if you're a spiritual person, the fragrance, you know, always, you don't age, to be honest. I see Swami Swaminis, Swamis and Swaminis,
They don't age. It looks old, but they're not aging because they're spiritual. Because Swami also, you know, these are very young. Of course, the last problem, the last minute, the things are different. But he was so many years, he was giving the fragrance, and you can see. Because we like to see Swami all the time the same way.
Today the program actually all prepared by my small daughter Dilki. So she's the one type. She said, "Oh, we're going to do like the test." I said, "Okay, right. You're in charge." So thank you, Dilki. So thank you very much, everyone who are today participating in our bhajan. And so prasada means other side. Please enjoy yourself and meet each other, the brother Ravi, and have a chat. So then we'll see you in New Year. Jai Sai Ram. Have a nice weekend.